In this video, I want to cover a viewer request. So in this problem, we have a FGM rectangular plate with a certain width, height and length. And the case which we want to study is shown here in table 2. Here this red marked. So height to width is 1 to 100. And the buckling load is 0.26 meganewtons. The functionally graded plate is simply supported at all edges and we have uniaxial compression. And in this case, the P is 1. And that means that the variation of the elasticity modulus is linear, which can be seen here. So P is 1, we have here a linear function. And somewhere here is also the material data. Here aluminium, 70,000, and I think this should be ceramic or something. 380,000 megapascal. Okay, now let's go to Abacus. We start from scratch. We will build a plate, solid extrusion. And we will make the plate 100 mm in length, in width, and 1 mm in height. So the coordinates are 50 and 0 and minus 50 and 1. Okay, now we have our plate. Now we create a coordinate system. So you can see it is in the middle of this edge and we have basically here 0 and here is 1 in y coordinate. Okay, now we go to property, create our FGM. We need here this and this one and then this, and so we have only a linear variation of the elasticity modulus. So we have the coordinate 0 and 1, so this is a y coordinate, and the elasticity modulus is, for example, 70,000 at the bottom and 380,000 at the top. And then we can plot this. So the coordinate and the variation of the elastic modulus. And then it looks like this, a linear function. And then we can get here the function. And here is it. This is a function which describes this linear curve, or linear function, whatever. So we can have here a field variable. So, and this is a coordinate. And then we need another row. And then we can just copy here. This is a coordinate. And then we assume the Poisson's ratio is constant. I don't know. And then it looks like this. And then okay. Then we go to Section Manager. Section FGM. Solid homogeneous. Okay. And then we assign the section. And okay. Okay, now we need to create some partitions for the boundary conditions. The first is like here, we want to cut it like this. So here in the middle, in this middle, and in the middle of the thickness. So here one, and 0.5. And then we use this, and then we create the partitions. Okay, and then we go to assembly. Then we go to step. We just perform a linear buckling analysis. So linear perturbation buckle. Like first 10 eigenvalues. Okay, and then we go to interaction and we create a reference point. So like here, reference point 1. Then we go to assembly, create some sets. First set is set RP1. And this is this point here. And then set RP1 edge. And this is this edge. So I selected here edges and then we only choose to select edges. Okay. Then we go to Constraint Manager, Equation, and here is 1 minus 1. The degree of freedom is 3, so in z-direction. And here we input the sets, so first edge and then the reference point. And the coefficient says that we have equal displacements. So if we put here in displacement, the same displacement is put on the edge. Okay, now to the boundary conditions. So simply supported means all the edges in the middle surface and then no out of plane displacement. So this edge, again here, edges, this edge, and then we can just rotate it. No, it's not that simple. Then, so I press Shift and Mouse click. So the left mouse button. And then here. And the final points are here. Again, Shift and Mouse left. And then done. And then just U2. So out of plane displacement. And then at the middle, we only select vertices. And then here for to log rigid body motions. Okay, and then concentrated force here. And then it's minus 1. Okay, and then we obviously need here some more nodes in order to map the through thickness variation. So we can do it like this. And for example, ach no, it's maybe too rough. Maybe like this. And then we have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 elements. That's enough, I guess. Okay, now to job. And I have here prepared the USD FLD. So we have the Young's modulus is dependent on the Y coordinate. And then we have here the field one variable and here the variable which we want to calculate. And here this is the function which we need. So 3 times E plus. Okay, and then we can save it. Save as and then here USD FLD FGM. Okay, this is USD FLD, very simple. Then we create the job plate 3D, FGM, continue, and then we link the USD FID. It's here. And then we run the job. So we have to get .26 meganewtons or 260,000 newtons. Okay, and oh, and I know why we have the wrong elements. Here we don't have can use reduced integration. So again, mesh with the correct elements. Because we haven't provided the reduced stiffness for the elements. So we just use the elements without reduced element, without reduced integration. Okay, and you see it's really fast. And you see we get about 260,000 newtons or 0.26 meganewton. Oh, we have to the state variable could also. So here this, and then run again. Okay, here again the results, and you can see here the variation of the elastic modulus. So at the top we have the ceramic and at the bottom the aluminium. And this is here the displacement field. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and until next time.